Hello everyone. Last time we have explained about first three methods of the fish preservation, such as chilling or refrigeration, deep freezing, and freeze drying. Today we are going to explain the next method of fish preservation, that is salting. Salting is very old and common practice used in fish preservation in India and other parts of the world. Salting is very old and the common practice or the method used in fish preservation in India and the other parts of the world. Salting is nothing but the partial dehydration of the fishes by osmosis with the salt, that is sodium chloride. Salting is nothing but the partial dehydration of the fishes by osmosis with the sodium chloride or salt. Due to intense salting, microbes or the bacteria are killed and diastasis is stopped. Salting is nothing but the partial dehydration of the fishes by the osmosis. So when we'll add the sodium chloride in a storage or in the container of the harvested fish with the adequate quantity or with the alternate layers of the fish and salt, leading into the dehydration of the fish by osmosis, and this also leads to destruction or killing of the bacteria or the microbes. This also prevents diastasis, that is decomposition or the spoilage of the harvested fish or the body tissues of the harvested fish. So due to the intense salting, microbes or the bacteria are killed and diastasis, that is decomposition or the spoilage of the body tissues of the harvested fish, is stopped. In this process, before salting, the heads of the fishes are removed, gutted and washed, and then salted as soon as possible. So while salting, the heads, then viscera, gills, all materials are removed, and fish is washed properly and then salted as soon as possible. So in this process, before salting, the heads of the fishes are removed, the viscera is also removed, gills are also removed, then washed properly and then salted or stored in the container, with either alternate layers of the fish and sodium chloride, that is salting as soon as possible. There are different methods of salting, such as dry salting, wet salting, or strong salting and cold salting. So in the process of salting, during salting, the heads of the fishes, gills of the fishes, and the viscera of the harvested fishes are removed and washed and then salted as soon as possible. There are different methods of salting, such as dry salting, wet salting. In wet salting, there are two methods, that is light wet salting and strong wet salting, and third, that is cold salting. There are different methods of salting, such as dry salting, wet salting, and cold salting. Dry salting is done with the use of sodium chloride in a dry condition in the storage of the harvested fish. Wet salting, that is the harvested fish is salted in a brine or a salt water, either containing 16% concentration of the sodium chloride or 25% concentration of the sodium chloride, that is lightweight salting or strong weight salting, and third one, that is cold salting, where for the salting purpose, together with the sodium chloride, the crushed ice is also used so as to maintain the cool condition in the storage while salting. So there are different methods of salting, such as dry salting, wet salting. In wet salting, there are two types, that is lightweight salting and strong wet salting. Lightweight salting means the salting of the harvested fish in a sodium chloride solution containing either 16% concentration or 25% concentration of the sodium chloride in the water or in the brine. That is a wet salting, either called as light salting or strong salting. And third method, that is cold salting, where at the time of salting, together with sodium chloride, crushed ice is also used for the salting purpose, and thus is called as cold salting. So we'll explain the salting one by one. Dry salting. In this process, alternate layers of the fish and the salt are placed. It is called as dry salting. Dry salting means keeping harvested fish alternate layers of the fish and the salt in the container or in the storage, and is called as dry salting. Second, wet salting or a brine. In this process, the fishes are dipped in a salty water called brine. In wet salting, the fishes are dipped or kept in a salty water called brine. The brine or salt water of two concentration. The brine or salt water used of two concentrations, such as 16% and 25%. So in a wet salting, the fishes are dipped in a salty water called as a brine. The brine or salt water is of two different concentrations. In a light brine salt concentration is 16%. In a light wet salting, concentration of the salt is 16%. In a light brine, salt concentration is 16%, and in a strong brine, the salt concentration is 25%. After this salt water treatment, the fishes are dipped in a salt. So, wet salting is responsible for the penetration of the salt at the interior of the body tissues, and so as to preserve the interior tissues of the fish by the salt due to the penetration of the salt in a wet condition. So, wet salting is responsible for the salting of the body tissues at its interior. Wet salting is useful in a salting of the fish body or the body tissues at their interior, or this leads to the complete salting. The wet salting leads to the complete salting of the body tissues of the salted fish. Wet salting or brine. In this process, the fishes are dipped in salty water called as brine. The brine or salt water is of two different concentration. In a light brine, salt concentration is 16%, and in a strong brine, the salt concentration is 25%. After this salt water treatment, the fishes are dipped or kept in the dry salt or sodium chloride, that is a dry salting. after this salt water treatment, the fishes are deeped or kept in the dry salt. Then third method of salting, that is cold salting. In this process, salt and crushed ice is spread on the fishes. In cold salting, salt and crushed ice is spread on the fishes with the alternate layers of the fish and mixture of salt and crushed ice during the cold salting. In the process of cold salting, salt and crushed ice is spread on the fishes, or the fishes and salt and crushed ice are used with the alternate layers in the storage or in the container while cold salting. This process is carried out in the cold room only. This process, cold salting, is done. The process of cold salting is carried out in a cold room only, where temperature is maintained at 2 or 3 degrees centigrade. The process of cold salting is carried out in a cold room where temperature is maintained at 2 or 3 degrees centigrade. This is also called as light cold salting. Strong cold salting process is performed at the normal room temperature. Strong cold salting process is performed or carried out at the normal room temperature. Salting is very common practice adopted by the fishermen near sea shores. Salting is very common practice of fish preservation practiced or adopted by fishermen near sea shores. The small size fishes are sun dried and preserved for long period. So in the process of cold salting, salt and crushed ice is spread on the fishes with the alternate layers of the fish and the mixture of salt and crushed ice. This process is carried out in a cold room only, where temperature is maintained at 2 or 3 degrees centigrade. This is called as light cold salting. And strong cold salting is performed at the normal room temperature. So light cold salting is done at 2 or 3 degrees centigrade or in a cold room, where the alternate layers of the fish and mixture of salt and crushed ice is kept for cold salting. In a cold room at 2 or 3 degrees centigrade temperature, and this is called as light cold salting. The same procedure can be followed or carried out at the normal room temperature is called as strong cold salting. Salting is very common practice adopted by the fishermen near seashores. The small size fishes are sun dried and preserved for longer period. Then next method of fish preservation, that is drying. Drying is also a very common and old practice of the fish preservation adopted by tropical countries like India, Japan, China and others, where sun rays are very powerful to dry the fishes easily. Sunlight is the cheapest and abundant source of heat energy used for drying of the fish. By this method, small size fishes are dried. The fishes are kept for dehydration on a mat or for 3 to 5 days, and during this period, upturning of the fishes is continued. After complete dehydration, the dried fishes can be stored. These dried fishes are also used for making fish fertilizer. The larger fishes are cut into smaller fishes for easy drying or complete drying. However, this method is not perfect for long time preservation. So while drying the harvested fish, while drying the harvested fish, usually the smaller size pieces after harvesting are directly spread onto the mat along the sea beach and dried under the extreme heat of the sun. And we know the sun is the cheapest and sunlight is the cheapest and abundant source of the heat energy and is thus used for the drying of the fish. So drying is also a very old and common practice of fish preservation and is adopted by the tropical countries like India, Japan, China and others, where sun rays or sunlight are very powerful to dry the fishes easily. Sunlight is the cheapest and abundant source of heat energy used for drying purpose. By this method, small size fishes are dried. The fishes are kept for dehydration. The fishes are kept or spread for dehydration on a mat or for 3 to 5 days. And during this period, upturning of the fishes is continued so as to allow a complete drying of the fish. After complete dehydration, the dried fishes can be stored. After complete dehydration of the fishes under sunlight, the dried fishes are stored, and these dried fishes are also used for making fish fertilizer. The larger fishes are cut into smaller pieces for easy drying or to allow complete drying. However, this method is not perfect for long time preservation. Then another modified method of drying of the fish is a sun curing. It is little bit advanced method over simple sun drying. Sun curing is little bit advanced method over simple sun drying in which the body of fish is opened from the ventral side and viscera and gills are removed. Then the fish is washed and salted in the ratio of 1:3 to 1:8 salt to fish proportion, and which is related with size of the fish. So the sun curing is a little bit advanced method over simple sun drying, in which the body of harvested fish is opened from ventral side, the viscera and gills are removed, then fish is washed and then salted in the ratio of 1:3 to 1:8, that is salt to fish, which is related with the size of the fish. So in sun curing, what is the process? Sun curing or sun drying is modified process. Sun curing is the modified process of the drying. Sun curing is the modified process or little bit advanced method over simple sun drying, in which body of the fish is opened from the ventral side, the viscera and gills are removed, then fish is washed properly and then salted in the ratio of 1:3 to 1:8 salt to fish proportion, which is related with the size of the fish, and then dried. So while sun curing, the fish which is to be preserved is first gutted, that is viscera and gills are removed, washed properly, then salted in the proportion of 1:3 to 1:8, that is salt to fish, which is related with the size of the fish, and then sun dried. Sun curing means first there is a salting of the fish and then drying of the fish. At first the fish is salted. At first the fish is washed properly, gutted, viscera, gills are removed, washed properly, then salted, and then sun dried is called as sun curing. Then second, that is mona curing. It is similar to sun curing, but difference is that no incision is made in the body of the fish to remove the intestine and the gills. Mona curing is similar to sun curing, but difference is that no incision or the cut is made in the body of the fish to remove the intestine or viscera and the gills. These organs are directly removed from the mouth. The alimentary canal, gills, that is viscera, alimentary canal or gills are removed directly through the mouth without cutting the body of the fish, after which it is washed or salted and then sun dried is called as mona curing. So mona curing is similar to sun curing. Mona curing is similar to sun curing, but difference is that no incision is made in the body of the fish to remove the intestine and the gills. These organs are directly removed from the mouth, and further, such eviscerated or gutted fishes are cleaned or washed properly, then salted and dried as earlier, like sun drying. That is, during mona curing also, the fish is eviscerated, that is gutted, that is removal of viscera, gills, washing, then salting, and again drying of the fish in the under the sunlight, that is called as mona curing, and the viscera and gills are removed directly through the mouth without incision in the body of the fish to remove the intestine and the gills, and the organs are directly removed from the mouth. Then the eviscerated or gutted fishes are cleaned or washed properly, then salted and then dried directly under the sunlight as earlier, called as mona curing. Then third is wet curing. It is also like sun curing with the only difference in the packing of salted fish as such. Wet curing, it is also like sun curing with the only difference in the packing of the salted fish as such. This method is used only for preservation of the fatty fishes. Wet curing method of fish preservation is used only for the preservation of the fatty fishes, called as wet curing. Wet curing is also like sun curing with the only difference in the packing of the salted fish as such, and this method is used only for the preservation of fatty fishes. Then last method of the fish preservation, that is canning. Canning is expensive and lengthy process of fish preservation. Canning is expensive or costly and lengthy process of the fish preservation, and hence it is not commonly used. However, it is widely used in advanced countries like America, France, Japan and Spain for the preservation of good quality or desired species of the fishes. Canning is expensive or costly and lengthy process of fish preservation, and hence it is not commonly used for the preservation of the fish. However, it is widely used in the advanced countries like America, France, Japan, and Spain. This is lengthy, costly, expensive, or complicated, but a very advanced process of preservation. This is lengthy. Canning is the lengthy, complicated, but very advanced process of fish preservation. In this process, the best quality pieces are selected. In this process, the best quality pieces are selected. Their viscera heads are removed. In this process, the best quality fishes are selected. Their heads and viscera are removed. Then these eviscerated fishes are treated with the bream or salt water, then washed, dried, and cooked in olive oil. This process is used to remove the excess of water for 2 to 5 minutes. Then the cooked fishes are packed in olive oil in a tins or the cans and sealed and then sent to the markets. So the canning is an expensive process of fish preservation, and hence it is not commonly used. Since the canning is expensive process of fish preservation, hence it is not commonly used for the fish preservation. However, it is widely used in advanced countries like America, France, Japan, and Spain. This is lengthy, complicated, but very advanced process of preservation. In this process, the best quality fishes are selected and their heads and viscera are removed. Then these eviscerated pieces are treated with a bream or a salt water, then washed, then dried and cooked in olive oil. The eviscerated pieces, the eviscerated or gutted pieces are treated with the bream or salt water, then washed, then dried and cooked in olive oil. This process is used to remove excess of water for 2 to 5 minutes. Then the cooked fishes are packed in olive oil in tins or cans and sealed and then sent to the markets. This is called as canning. So this is what all about the fish preservation techniques. So we have explained all the type of fish preservation techniques, starting with chilling or refrigeration, then deep freezing, then freeze drying, then salting. In salting, we have explained dry salting, wet salting, cold salting. Then we have explained the fish preservation technique, that is a drying. In a drying, there are again 3 methods, that is sun curing, mono curing, and wet curing. And the last method of fish preservation, that is canning. So this is what all about fish preservation technique. So with this, we have completed the entire syllabus of the topic fisheries. So with this, we'll stop here. Thank you.